What's going on, traders? How we doing out there? I know that you guys have seen it. We got a word of the day. We were going to look for natural gas. I'll let you guys know all about my swing trade, taking a shot right there in natural gas. Also going to take a look, of course, what's going on in oil. Why are we not moving up? But shouldn't we be moving on up? Wartime, right? I was trading MRO today, got a little bit of a move on up, actually ended up stopping on out of the name, even though it went up at the gates. We'll talk about that trade also, and stick around. We got some other things to talk about. Of course, gold, and what can I say, man? I love gold, baby. Welcome to Money Mitch. Let's get it started.
It's time for Money Making Mitch. When investors need a story, we're going to the moon. Welcome to Money Mitch, where story is everything. I'm here to find you the next opportunity. It's all about the green hands. Now we all know the bull market is here to stay. Money Mitch.
What's going on, team? Yes, you know it. Brendo knows it's time for the money, guys. Let's get it going, guys. Time to get the money picks going here. Let's take a look at what happened in the market today. What did we see going on out there, guys? You guys hit the thumbs on up if you guys are having a good market day. I know the market's coming down, but I don't know if you guys see. My mood's up, guys. I've been enjoying it. One of the things that I'm happy about is right here on Money Mitch, what have we been talking about? We've been talking about inflationary trades, guys. That's the main thing that we've been looking at. And one of the areas that we've been looking at is basic materials. And with that basic materials, what have we been talking about? We've been talking about gold. We've been talking about coal. We even talked about a little bit about silver. I'm not the biggest silver fan, so I'm not going to act like I'm a silver fan. But also aluminum doing well. And one that is surprising me that isn't really breaking on out yet is steel. And so I'm going to keep an eye out on steel to see what happens here. But this is exactly what we want to keep an eye out is the inflationary trade was what we were watching to begin with, because I felt that inflation would be sticky and that the Fed would run into a problem there deciding how fast do we hike these rates or how do we gain control of this inflation. Now there's a whole nother problem, guys. There's the Russian problem. And of course, we know how that's been affecting the market. So I want to give you guys a shout out. Give me a thumbs on up if you guys have been enjoying it. Also, if you guys have been here and listening to me talk about this and maybe made some trades off this, hey, let me know those stories because that's what really makes me happy. It's not necessarily giving you guys a trade that you guys, like, let's say, copy me, because that's not going to get me any benefit in life. And that's not going to get you. Maybe it gives you a monetary gain, just one trade, but that's not what it's about. What I want to hear is that how you guys are taking some information that you guys might hear right here on Money Mitch and making it your own, making your own trading, investing decisions and nailing those trades. That's what I want to be hearing. So big thumbs on out. I do see a lot of people in the chat joining on in. It looks like we got the riffraff in the house. What's going on? The blind trader. How are we doing out there? Blind trader, I feel like there's a stock that you wanted me to take a look at. Please throw it up in the chat. Make sure I get to that. I don't want to miss it. I got a lot of things on my mind right now, but definitely want to go ahead and touch it. Shannon in the house. Next war, I'm going gold. Hey, you know it. Tiny, might have to change that end to the intro. Yeah, there might be a bear market eventually. I mean, hey. Who knows? We need an updated intro. I hear you. A1 property investments start each day with the love of money. Got to do it. Ashton in the house. Let's go. Richard, what's up? All right, guys, let's go ahead. Let's look at the market. What did we see out there? So steel is definitely going to be one that I'm keeping on watch as an industry to give you guys something to watch right out the gates, give you guys some value. If you guys appreciate giving you that industry to watch, smash the thumbs on up. Let's see if we can get 50 likes right out the gates today. All right, so the SPY, really, I mean, we were talking about this, right? Is this a dead cat bounce that we had when we started bouncing on up? We talked about this trend line, how we've been holding that trend line. And yesterday we talked about how we were between this 434 and 428. That was the downside action that I could see continued downside action. And today, what do? We actually break below that here, and then we bounce quickly reversed right back underneath, kind of a VWAP fade setup. If you guys know what the VWAP fade is, that's when you break down big and come back towards the VWAP and then immediately fade off of that, holding any prior support or resistance. Let's say you're using the 480s, the 430s there, and you went after it right over here in the VWAP. The VWAP was at 429.69. You could have been risking about 40 cents on this trade. The stock kind of ticks up there and immediately closes right back below that VWAP. And then you get a nice flush down action. I know that some people took some options in that SPY trade. I don't trade the SPY, but if you did take those options, that's how I kind of would attack these. And hey, power to you. Let's keep it going. Let's go. Is that Duvo? Hey, I like it. What's going on? Let's do this. Jim Cruz in the house. Appreciate the love, guys. Let's keep going. All right, so areas to watch. One of the things that I like to do is definitely talk about why I'm focusing on certain areas. So one of the areas that I'm focusing on now is, of course, what is our focus word? Our focus word right now is natural gas. Why is that such a focus, right? And so the big thing is the Russian and Ukraine crisis is forcing a change like none other, right? So the European Union is making actually plans right now for far-reaching to break from Russian oil and gas. Of course, there's trying to split from Russian energy because of what's going on right now. And they're actually expected to announce this next week. So just pay attention. And that's why I'm keeping an eye out. If they're going to start pulling back from that Russian oil and gas, I can tell you right now, one thing I did the research into natural gas, and I could see, man, this could be a driver for the price of natural gas like we've never seen it. Europe just went through a really troubled time trying to meet the need, and they got the supply eventually, but the prices were skyrocketing. This could make prices go way higher than even that peak that we just saw. So that's why I'm watching some natural gas trades. I'll give you guys the swing trade that I took here. Let's take a look. So I took, we're gonna take a look here, and I took here LNG, and I'm going to also give you another one, a laggard play to keep an eye out on. So I took LNG here around the 118s. I got 118.20s, but like always, I'm going to just round it to 118 here. And so that way we can take a look. This is LNG. This is a gas play here, kind of the Russian play here that could really start making some moves here. I'm keeping an eye out on these major players. Of course, there's another one that you guys can watch, and it actually didn't have the best day. But I really like the hourly action that we got today. We were just uptrending. Now I'm going to look for a hold of this 118 tomorrow. It could come slightly below, but taking out 120 on the upside is what I need to see. So Fling is the other one that I'm going to give you guys to take a look at. Today it pulled back, but I'm going to keep a watch on this one because I feel like people were loading the boat a little bit early on this one. I think it could pull back, let's say, closer towards 21 and then eventually just get right back up there towards 23, eventually taking out this 2370. This is one that I'll keep on watch. I'm not in this one, FLNG, but it is the laggard, and you guys know how I like to play leaders and laggards. Look for something, like if you get a story, right, you look for something to start leading it, maybe an industry leader to really start moving the stocks. Then look at other stocks in the industry. Are they coming to support? Are they bouncing off support? Look at those stocks. You might be able to catch those when the big one moves. Then you see the laggard just start coming into an effect and setting up that good trade. Those are the trades that I really like also. Let's keep going. Let's take a look at some of the stocks that you guys are mentioning in the chat. And I'll get into, of course, the coal trade. Guys, I don't know if you guys have been noticing, but man, BTU has been an absolute monster. Looks like in after hours, we're getting hit a little bit hard here. I wonder if this is earnings. I haven't taken a look here. But BTU, what a monster rip here, guys. If you take a look here on this is the 15-minute chart, or you can use the one-hour chart to kind of make it a little bit cleaner. I'm going to make it a little cleaner for us on the 1 hour and take a look here at what you saw. So the price action that we saw would be, of course, the pattern of three. We talk about this all the time here on Money Mitch. Can you get these three topping patterns? And then you look for a move to support to hold. And if you look here, We come right back towards that support. We hold, and then we break on out on that fourth attempt to push through. This is why it's so important to kind of watch these, look for these to kind of play on out. I take a look at these also on the daily. You can see these, how they start pointing there. If we can get back through that 18, of course, this is going to be looking strong. BTU, the coal play there, guys. Definitely keep your eyes on that one. I know I will. And like always, the coal trade is one of those trades that has probably been one of the biggest trades in a decade here. If you guys remember, we've been watching BTU and really been pointing it out since February 1st when it was in this sideways consolidation. It broke out, gave this bullish engulfing candle here. We still have the box around it, and you can clearly see, you know, it says right there, 2-1. And that's when we created that line, and it was right there on that day. February 1st, we saw that as the sign getting strong. And now from that moment, I mean, this has gone and ran about 50%. BTU, crazy trade there. And we'll keep watch. There's other coal trades you guys can keep on watch. ARCH is one that I've been watching also, and it just started getting strong today. Look at this nice bottoming action, had a couple days, then went sideways. Now you got that bullish engulfing candle. I'm going to be looking for this to get above the 120s and try to take out the 125s. This is a coal play. Let's keep moving, guys. Let's go. All right, DJ Music Mitch. Oi, I have some song sounds to heal us from the market beatings. Hey man, I have to maybe play some reggae tunes on the way on out. But since this is only 30 minutes, I'm trying to get through a lot. I see 112 people here. Do me the favor, drop a like, and let's keep it going. All right, so other areas that we can keep a watch, right? And so energy is the one area that I've been struggling a little bit here with oil. I thought we would get a break on out today. If you guys can see here, I'm going to show you guys. I was looking at this on the 15-minute, saw this pullback, was thinking that we were going to get a push back towards 2031s. It actually ended up dropping through my wrist here of 2191s into the red zone. And I'm just wondering, you know, can we get back into my green zone? My green zone's above 2230s. So I'm going to definitely keep a watch on that to see if we can get into here and then really start pushing in oil again. But for right now, oil has been fighting to break on out. And I'm concerned because, I mean, at the end of the day, it should kind of break on out with this Russia news, but it still hasn't really got going. To me, this could have been maybe it's a sell the news moment that so many people load up the boat. It is a loaded trade. It has a lot of people watching it. So maybe we get some late reaction. We'll see what happens in the oil trade. All right. As you guys can see, consumer cyclicals definitely got hit hard today, but gambling wasn't the worst. DraftKings having a good day, so definitely you DraftKings traders, I'm sure you guys enjoyed seeing it bounce back a little bit today. To tell you the truth, I never expected to see DraftKings down here by 18s and 20s, but I think this is kind of getting towards an area that I might even take a shot as an investor in because I do like the name, but we're just completely out of favor. And my question is, what can come into favor for DraftKings? I don't see any catalyst right now. I know states and by states are going to keep adding to the bottom line, but I mean, you don't have much. Baseball isn't that high in gambling, and so I just don't know. I think we might have to wait all the way until football comes back, but we'll see what happens. All right, so Tesla being mentioned in the chat, would I buy it now? And as you guys can see, I've been talking about the bottoming action and how this looked like a bearish chart. And until we get back above this 950, that's why there's a green mark here. I'm not bullish on Tesla. I'm bearish on Tesla. And you can see bearish trend continued, and it broke down hard today, guys. A lot of that was yesterday. We even talked about it. It was at the 200-day moving average. 200-day moving average was giving it a good look. If it could hold that, it was going to be fine. Today, what ended up happening, it broke down big from there, and that was that level right around here, around the 830s, and you just flushed down, and you didn't stop. This, where could Tesla be going? We did a measurement of this, and if you kind of measure right here, the breakdown kind of moved down towards that green, you get about 200. So from the breakdown point, I'm going to go ahead and draw it right here. To me, this is going to be right here around, let's say, 860s or 850s. And so you would want to go ahead and calculate about 200 points down from there. So you're thinking, I'm thinking 660s it could even come down to. And why? That's just a measurement of the flag. Where's around 660s? Let's see. All right. So we're looking around here. And so let's see if there's any support there that we see. All right. So we see kind of right around here. I do see some support around the 650s. That's kind of the level that I'd give for support for Tesla here. If it can come back to 650s, I'll get a little bit interested. But right now, it's in free fall mode. All right. I was thinking 700. Well, I just did the measurement. That's how I did it there, guys. It's not necessarily my number. It's literally from the breakdown. I measure the flag, and I measure that from the extension on the breakdown. What you think of MRO oil play? We just talked about that, Sam. I don't know if you want to just rewind a little bit. Maybe you just joined. If you just joined, then, hey, just rewind a little bit. Catch what I talked about, MRO. I have been looking at this, but it's a confusing trade right now, oil. Petitioning the J Raz for the Money Mitch pole position post-market show. Whoa, whoa, whoa. That's a lot in that sentence. I don't even know if J Raz will enjoy that one. The pole position? Nah, we'll give him the pole position. We got to get him on the show for sure. Jason's a busy man. I'll tell you that much. He's definitely busy as of late. Let's take a look here at some other stocks that are trading and what you could be looking at. All right. So one of the things that I've been doing is giving kind of a watch list on live trading. If you guys look here, one of the stocks that I was alerted to today, and I gave an alert in our Discord. We have a Discord that is for the live trading stream. So if you guys are part of the live trading stream and you want to keep joining the community, let me know. I can maybe throw up that link in the Discord here. But I called out TAP. Why did I call out TAP? Because it hit my alert line. I've been drawing this kind of channel and looking for it to get back above that channel. And today we finally pushed through here on the 50 breakout. And so now I'm starting to look, is TAP really moving here? TAP is, of course, Molson Coors Brewery here. I could use a beer right now. So we'll see what happens. But this one also has a good chart. One, two, three attempts to break out. Now that we broke on out, we want to make sure that it holds kind of this 50 area on any pullbacks. So as long as it holds that on pullbacks, I would be looking for this to kind of get up there and take out that 52. I do like this trade. I was actually watching it. And if you see today, what happened? High relative volume, guys. Look how the volume goes from 1 million to like about 2. Let me see the exact amount here. To about 2.4 million. And then today you close at 4.5 million of the shares traded. Definitely some people starting to take a look at TAP. I would keep a watch on this one. And for that being mentioned, look for the laggard to turn around, which is Sam's. Sam's would be turning around and finding a bottom and bouncing a little bit. That's probably what I'll be looking for tomorrow. If that happens, if you see Sam just kind of like push on up here towards 379s, I'd be looking for TAP to kind of go ahead and keep that push that we saw today. You can see another thing that I like about TAP is that it consolidated in the top part of the price range, showing you that what buyers control, and we'll see if it can continue to push the stock here. That's TAP. All right, guys, we're about at 449 here. I can get into some other stocks here from my watch list, or I could take stocks from you guys out there. You guys see it here. I put the whole watch list out there. Another one that did good today was another gold trade, guys. NEM, definitely need to get into my gold trade. Yes, yes, I said it, guys. I love gold, and what can I say, guys? I mean, it's been a great time for gold, and we've been killing it. A little sprinkle on my gold trade. Let's take a look here. AU finally getting on up there. Yesterday we drew what? A circle, guys. We said, all right, so what do we want to see if we're going to continue in this trade, right? If we're going to continue in this trade, we want this trend to continue holding, right? And so as long as the trend continues to hold, we're looking good here. And so you can draw a line on up there, or you could follow the 9 EMA. This held sideways for a couple days. And so what we do is we drew a line here around the 23 and we said, okay, look how this was drawn from what? On the 22nd, this was drawn towards the 23 breakout into that 24. We're looking a move into this box. We actually created this box on the 14th of February. So that's how long we've been kind of trading this and looking for this move. Now we're going to look for the continued move into 24. Once we get into 24, we're going to take another third of this off. We took half of it. Now we're going to take a third, and we're going to keep that last little piece to let the last little piece run. It's right now about 9%, getting into that 10% mode. That's where I want to take some of it off and then let it try to work a little bit more. But of course, always be willing to take the profit after that 10%. All right, time to get to stocks from the chat. You guys throw a like. If you guys throw a like and throw a stock, I'll go ahead and cover it. Let's get through some of these. I know you got a lot of stocks to take a look at, but hey, let's run through them. Check out NFE for a natural gas play. Hey, you put one on my radar, I will definitely take a look, guys. That's what it's all about. So if you see here, this has been in a retrace on the weekly. You almost retrace 100% of the move. And there's a resistance here from kind of this consolidation. So that's, I think, what you ran into. Yeah, you ran right into that. Look how right here at the 1950s. And so that's the kind of the consolidation area. Now, one thing I do see is what one, two, and it looks like you kind of come down and make a third low around here. So what I would do here is I would draw a trend line just to make sure that I'm not going to be a little bit early to the gun. I want to see the stock start trading up here before I really get into this one. Of course, you could see a gap up there to 25 immediately, but I want to see it kind of push on up there first, because I do think that you could get a little bit of a pullback and then eventually get another extension on up there towards the 25. That's how I'd be watching NFE. Palladium, that's another one. PAL. I mean, I can't trade all of them. I can't trade all the basic materials, even though I wish I could. But if you take a look here on the daily, I do like this chart. Draw a trend line here, draw a horizontal line there, and then you can draw a trend line from this high. And you can see how you held it on pullback. That is what you want to see, this kind of push above, hold, and then clear. Yesterday was actually the clear day. Today you got the continuation and a nice hold of that 2213 or 2020 number. So to me, I think now you kind of look at that 2020 number as being that spot that you're going to watch to see if it keeps holding to keep in that bullish sense. So if you got into this one today, that's what I'd be watching. That 220 stands out to me. PAL, palladium trade. Are you bullish overall energy sector? Yeah, I mean, overall, I have to be bullish here. We're on the brink of war, guys. I mean, I haven't seen, you know, us mention anything about us, our troops being, you know, put into areas of danger. But I'll tell you right now, this is a real sign of concern if it continues and continues to escalate. The only thing that's going to be affected, I think, just massively, really quickly, is that inflationary trade. And the inflation just keeps going on up. And so that's what I'm watching to take advantage of. And I got to make some of that money back, right? I mean, if my inflation and all my cash is going to nothingness, I got to try to make some of that money back. BP, let's take a look there. BP, Larry Hill bringing in this one. Of course, it's been trying to break on out. And this looks to me just like MRO. It had such a good look. In the last couple of days, we've had better information for the upside for oil, and this has not broken out. So what I would do is I draw a trend line here from this wick here and just draw those wicks down. And you need to see this stock get up in there towards 32 tomorrow to really show you that, hey, we want to come up there to take out 34. And I would want to see a close actually above 33 to get me confident here. I'll show you guys exactly that trade. This is BP as it's been pulling on back. You could see that you tried to push above here before, up one, down one, up two, down two, up three, then came back down. And it actually is on the breakdown and holding it on the upside. You want to see that breakout, a close back above here into the 33s is what I would be looking for on BP. Roku. Missed trades, let's go. All right, so Roku actually trying to come back for that fill, but I think it's going to come closer towards that 101 before it gets towards up here towards the fill of that gap, which is 143.23s. Honestly, this is one of those harder trades. I have for a while, I wanted to start trading more of these kind of these gap fill trades. But in an environment like this, I just don't know if it's the best trade. Like always, make your own investment advice on Roku. I don't know which way is going to go from here. The only thing I know is that I personally wouldn't want to try to get these because it's not my bread and butter, these shadow fills. But like always, if you like it, smash the like. Let's keep going. All right, guys, we got over 179 people here. Do me the favor, guys. Smash that like. Let's keep going here. Let's see what we're at on the like front here. Looks like we're at 85 likes, guys. Come on, let's get it up to 100. Let's go, let's go. ABBV, yeah, this has been a strong one that most people aren't just paying attention to. So this has been pretty strong here, has been trying to push on out. As you guys can see, I had this line drawn from February 22nd. I was looking at this one, I guess, yesterday. Someone had to have called this one out. You can see the bottoming support levels that we broke out of. I do like those levels now as they're keep holding on this sideways action. Look for it to come back and kind of take out the daily highs here. That's a pretty good look there as you're looking to take on out here at 147. That's the level I would be watching tomorrow. From this level, I wouldn't want to see 145 break. It's okay to get back there for a little bit, but you really want to see a nice push on up here. One thing that is coming into play is a higher volume. So this one just feels like to me like it's holding trend, because if you really just draw here, look how this really held here. I'll make it green so that you guys can really see this line here. So you guys see this trend line, higher lows, and then you just made a higher low. Sometimes I really like using those deep trend lines to use them as entry. You could have got an entry on here on that pullback that you got on Tuesday, and this came towards 141.25. If you look here, it's right underneath that level. You could have been attacking that and trying to get in on that and then trying to get the move back towards resistance. XOM and gold. XOM still fighting. I just don't understand. I'm going to be looking for this to get back into the 80s, but for right now, it just doesn't look good in oil. And to tell you the truth, like I've said before, it has me a little bit confused there. Forward being mentioned, Zachary. Let's go. Forward coming on down there. I've talked about how I've been looking for it to come into this major trend line here. Let's take a look here on the weekly. Why do I like this major trend line? Because you can draw this major trend line all the way from the pandemic, and you can see here how we held it each time. Now we're coming on back towards that trend line. That's going to be up in this area. So we're talking about price points into, let's see, what's the 50 at there? That's 1586. So somewhere in that 1580s and below, that's where I'm going to be interested into the 15s on forward for it to come back, catch that bottom, catch that trend line, and reverse. Like I talked about, those deeper time frame trend lines, I do like to make some buys off of them. All right, let's go ahead. Met holding up better than most can. You cover Met? Let me take a look here. Met Life insurance stock here. That's not a bad one to keep on watch. Yeah, it is holding up well. I mean, relative, you can't really be upset about this move. And I would just see, all right, so as long as it comes back and holds kind of the breakout level, which is around 66, 67. So maybe you want to pull that down towards this support, 65, 60s. Now you're looking for that to catch there and get back towards the 70. It's not a bad one, but it also isn't the biggest returner, or isn't the biggest return. All right, 88 keys on the likes. Let's go. Green hands in a bear market. It's only one way, guys. It's not always trading the same kind of stocks. You guys will see me move stocks. Sometimes I'm talking about solar stocks. I was talking about that in October and September. Sometimes I'm talking about gambling stocks. Right now, what is my focus? I'm learning about oil, gold, coal. It's all about being rotationary. This is the one thing that definitely helped me when I moved out of day trading to more of a swing trade approach and to really get that bread and butter. So let's keep going. Let's see what other trades are out there. Can you take a look at CRDO? All right. All right, CRDO, this is relatively newer company, so it's a little bit harder to judge. But the only thing that I have to go off of is kind of this resistance where you got above and broke down below. So to me, higher and higher lows, right? We just talked about it. Higher lows, higher lows, higher lows. As long as it can hold here around 15, not get to 1450, I still like the name. But this is just off of the very little chart that I have here. And it'd be better if you could actually see the chart, right? And so you see how you get above here. You finally get it above, but what does it do? It actually closes back into the pattern. So you want to see that trend line hold on the bottom, higher lows, higher lows, higher lows, higher lows, and then get back up there through the 1550, break out above 16, but you don't want to see it back by 14. All right, let's keep going. How low can Tesla go? If you actually rewind, I went into Tesla, measured my kind of measurement for where I think support could come into play. But like always, do your own risk assessment. Let's go ahead. Let's keep it going here. Nice tub. Starbulk, SBLK. Not a bad trade there. It has been doing pretty well. This is a shipping and port company. This looks like an inflationary trade right here. That's might be running out of steam here a little bit, but definitely has had a great February. If you look here from February, Starbulk is up about, what we got here, 42% there. So it's definitely been a monster. What I like about this one is that it's very symmetrical. Very rare do you get a stock here in the shipping industry to actually be symmetrical with the patterns and kind of follow that. So it's not a bad stock there, SBLK. All right, eBay earnings. If that's earnings, then we can tell it was bad, guys. I can look it up if you really need the numbers, BNZ. But what I would recommend, if you do need the numbers, get Benzinga Pro, free 2-week trial. All you need is sign on up, pro.benzinga.com. Boom, you don't even need a credit card. 2-week trial, go ahead and check it on out, guys. QCOM looks good, short for filling the gap. Let's take a look there. All right, QCOM here at 161. We'll see if this one can continue to break on down. I've talked about how this one just completely went out of favor. Now it looks like it really wants to break on down through the lows of 161. Big support there. Next level from there, it could probably come down towards this 153.30s. And so we'll see what happens there. eBay was one I actually was shorting here during this time, and I wish I would have held it, guys. I nailed a short through this kind of level here for eBay, and man, I could have been shorting this at 65 and still holding. So definitely eBay turning around there and hasn't come back since that time. That was actually created on January 10th. That's when I was looking at that one. So if we want to specifically call out a candle, that would be this candle right here. ARLP, let's go. Coal trade, I talked about this one, guys. This is one that I'm going to keep on watch. Look at the weekly. Look for it to come back up there towards the 14. That's what I'd say about ARLP is use the weekly so that you can get around some of the volatility. It's not the biggest volatility, but it does kind of move some range here. And a lot of times does the pullbacks here on the weeklies. So that's why I would call out the weekly for ARLP. Let's go. GDX. Yeah, of course. GDX gold trade you could look at. I'm sure it's probably pushing. There you guys have it. I've been talking about this one. This one looks like a laggard type of trade. Just started going kind of in the last 2 days, in the last 3 weeks, and now has been going sideways. We'll look for the takeout of 35 tomorrow. This could be a good one for a day trade. What does this one have? Bottoming action, guys. One, two, three. On the fourth, look for recovery reversal. Boom. Look at that baby go as GDX red rum. Let's go. Let's go. Hit them likes. I hope you guys are enjoying the show. All right, guys, we're in overtime here. I will keep going, but only if we get right now up to 150 likes in the next 2 minutes. I'm going to do one more stocks. We got 109 likes right now. I will keep going, but you guys got to smash that like. All right, let me go ahead and see what other stocks are being thrown out here. You guys know I love to get you guys some of that money. Let's keep it going here. Money. Don't worry, you're not the only one that's saying you don't understand sometimes. One thing that you guys will hear me do is try to be transparent. When I'm feeling on top of it, I'm going to call it out. When I'm not feeling it, when I'm a little confused, I'm going to also tell you, hey guys, I just don't see it right now. I'm not understanding. This is not making logical sense. So that's when sometimes you just got to be careful and we'll see what happens. What is the number one oil ticker? For me, I like the way MRO trades because it likes to trend, but I've also traded XOM. I mean, but you can look at many different oil trades. Do you see a pullback in gold? It can't happen. It definitely can't happen, but I think we already got some of that action where you did get some sideways action. If you look here on GOLD, you got two sideways actions on that. GDX, we just saw 2 days of sideways action on that. And then let's take a look at the other one that I was trading, AU, two days of sideways action on that. So to me right now, I don't see a pullback. I could see a continuation move, maybe day two move of this push out of the range. Who knows CDC indicator? The CDC indicator, which, what do you mean by the CDC indicator? Maybe elaborate a little bit more on that. All right, let's go ahead. Have a good one, Shannon. It's good to have you like always. Did we get the likes? Now I'm going to have to go get on out of here. No, we didn't get the likes, guys. Come on. Thought you would get the likes there. All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap on up there. Hope you guys had a great trading day and keep busy. Learn how to understand rotationary plays. I think that's so important because we'll never know exactly where the market is going, right? We can never know, like, I'm no genius. I don't have no crystal ball. I don't pull it up under my desk and say, okay, so growth trades in November. No, what I try to do is I try to always do sector and industry analysis. Looking at the sectors, what is moving, what it isn't, where is the macro headlines moving to? That's why in December, I started looking at energy plays because it made sense. It's what happened the prior year. And you start looking at what in winter, you look for energy plays to do well. That's just kind of a common sense type of play there that actually expanded to being something even greater. And that's why we've been looking at this area since the beginning of the year and really taking charge of it in February. In January, we probably didn't make the biggest gains on these oil and gold trades and inflationary trades. But now in February, we've been taking advantage because we were eyes open and looking for the moves and reacting to it. And that's how we got this AU trade. That's how we're going to continue to trade. And like always, catch me on live trading. We'll be back, guys. We're going to keep it going. I'll be back tomorrow on live trading. That starts at 9:05. Don't miss it. I'll be ready to take some more trades. And we'll see how my swing trade kind of works on out. LNG, guys. So take a look there. We'll see if natural gas can really get moving. And like always, if you guys want to see something else on Money Mitch or something that maybe you guys like and you guys want to see me expand on it, then let me know in the comments below. I'll see you next time. Hit the thumbs on up. Until then, keep it rocking, guys. Let's go. Let's go. Sprinkle a little bit of that gold. Let's go.